Can you confirm that this transmission is being received? Ah, excellent. Thank you, Stilgar. Your cooperation and assistance in this matter will be handsomely rewarded, as promised, and as soon as I am able to step foot on Arrakis. Greetings, my dear Fremen of Arrakis. My name is Professor Clemmons, and as your tribe leader Stilgar briefed you on, I am broadcasting to you here from my own sietch, known as Arkham Sanitarium for Mental Rehabilitation, on the distant planet in my homeworld of Earth, a planet that is not entirely all that different than Duke Paul Atreides' birth world of Caladan. Now, before we go any further, I would like to take a moment to thank those of you who have been selected from your various tribes across the deserts of Arrakis and have volunteered to participate in this experiment. Now, at this time, I would like to ask you, if you have not already done so, if you should be able to find a device of this nature by your side, and if you would be so kind as to place it over your head so that the pads rest comfortably upon your ears. This will enable you to hear me up close and personal, as if I were right there next to you. I do regret and deeply apologize for not being there presently in your midst. There are matters here at the facility for which I am a director, a position that is not all that entirely different than Stilgar or Duke Paul Atreides, or Muad'Dib, as you refer to him, I believe. Just allow me a moment to set these aside. Now, about the nature of this broadcast. I have been in talks with Muad'Dib over the last few months after the situation occurred between your tribes and the Harkonnens and Sardaukar. That event that transpired, where the Emperor sent his fleet to dispatch of Paul Atreides and the Fremen as well. And these talks that I have had with the Duke, Muad'Dib, concerning an arrangement where I would be receiving an allotment of the melange or spice, as well as a young and adult maker or sandworm for test purposes, as I have not yet seen such a creature with my own eyes, and I wish to learn all that I can about them. And then I began to have thoughts about the conflict that occurred between your people and the Harkonnens and Sardaukar, and that is why I have arranged for this test, this experiment. I know that you and many of your tribe live in a very stressful environment and have suffered many losses, friends, families, during the confrontation with the Emperor and his fleet. And that is why I would like to introduce to you what I call ASMR, the Arkham Sanitarium method of relaxation. By using various visual stimuli, such as this calming hand motions, reaching out to you to remove any stress. If you would just visualize it, and through the use of various objects and the sounds that they create, such as my own hands, sound of various fabrics, and various other stimuli and sounds, and these methods often invoke in the recipient a peculiar feeling. You may refer to it as a tingling sensation that cascades from your scalp down to your neck, your shoulders, various other parts of one's body, and thus that is the nature of this special broadcast. Again, were it not for circumstances that keep me here at Arkham Sanitarium, I would be there with you on Arrakis, performing these very same methods in person. Now, while I cannot be there, I believe Stilgar has introduced you to my brother, Corvus Clemmons, the dark-robed individual with the pointed mask. And I believe you have also been introduced to my wife, who is also my assistant. Not unlike Duke Paul Atreides' concubine, Hera, or the former Duke Leto's wife, Jessica. They have been sent on my behalf for the other reason for this broadcast and for the talks and the discussions that I have had with Muad'Dib. We would like to recruit some of you to travel here to Earth and take up residency here at Arkham Sanitarium so that I myself can perform these tests and other experiments that I think you will find very beneficial on you in person. And in exchange for your leaving your home and loved ones on Arrakis, you will be able to witness for once what the future of Arrakis will look like when you come here to live on planet Earth. So, I do apologize for such a lengthy introduction, as I do think it was necessary for me to explain and be transparent with the nature of this transmission. So, without any further delay, why don't we get started? Now, I'm going to perform the first test, which I have given you a glimpse of earlier. Just follow my hands and my fingers, and let the calm and slow motion help your mind to relax and become more at ease. You should feel your eyelids beginning to get heavy in a very calm, feeling should begin to pass over your body and your mind. And now I am just going to draw in the air . And if you begin to feel a very pleasant tingling sensation, please be sure to let my brother, the plague doctor, know, or my assistant, Margaret, because you will be a prime candidate for a transfer from Arrakis the sanitarium here on Earth. Just drawing various symbols and shapes, some that you may be familiar with, and others that you might not be. And then we can draw a protective barrier . Just imagine that this barrier protects you like your still suits protect you. Although this barrier does not offer any ability to reclaim water from your body, it does offer you metaphysical protection. It's all in your mind. Just relax. I know you have a very difficult life on that planet. The heat and how difficult it is. Maintain a supply of water. And I know that you have been working very diligently on terraforming Arrakis into what one day will be a Caladan or an Earth. And that is very commendable. Both Stilgar and Muad'Dib have spoken highly about all of you and all of the different tribes you are associated with. How resilient and hardworking you are in trying to terraform Arrakis into what one day may be a Caladan or an Earth. Not to mention the highly skilled fighters and warriors that you are, especially the Thetakin, which, surprisingly and shockingly, were able to dispatch of the Emperor's Sardaukar, one of the most elite fighting militias in the universe. So it would seem that the Fremen, your people and your tribes, are both something to be in awe of. And to be feared, which is another reason why I'm hoping some of you will be willing to make the transition and trip to Arkham Sanitarium here on Earth. Is perform what we call an eye exam. This is something that I would do if I were there presently on Arrakis. I would ask you to look straight ahead at my finger while I check the dilation of your pupils. Although it would be very difficult to perform this test knowing how your eyes have been affected by the spice, which is another reason I'm hoping I will be able to just stare at my finger, if you will. Another reason I'm hoping that some of you will be willing to volunteer and become permanent residents here. The effect of the spice melange on your bodies is something that I'm very intrigued about, especially its effect on the mind. Now, if you'll be so kind as to just follow the light as it moves across your field of vision, while again it would be difficult to ascertain how well your eyes would be functioning due to the coloring of the spice. This particular eye follow test is again something that allows me to ascertain and identify any neurological issues you may be experiencing with your eyesight. And I would just hold up your eyelid and just take a look. And your right eyelid, lift that up. There. And that is just one of the types of exams and treatment methods that we perform on all of our residents and patients, which I'm hoping you will be more than willing to become a part of. Okay, well now I am going to explore the sounds of various objects that can be found here on my homeworld of Earth. And these are probably things that you have never seen before. much like the technology that you employ among the various sietches that you live, such as the glow globes and the moisture catchers, or the dew catchers, I believe, as well. So much technology. Yes. So much that I'm dying to get my hands on, which is yet something else I have been discussing with Stilgar. Some of your technology, and some of you as well, and a couple of makers, and some spice. I think that covers it. Well, let us continue with this experiment, and I do want to take a moment to say, if you happen to fall asleep at any point during this test, that is perfectly fine. It'll let my brother Corvus and my assistant Margaret know that you make for prime candidates to join us here at Arkham Sanitarium. So, let me show you some of the items and various objects that you'll find here, not only in the sanitarium that we use and employ for various tests, such as this one, but what has been created with and is a product of human technology here on Earth. The first item I have for you is what is known as a cutting mat. I use this for, as the name suggests, cutting various things. And as you can hear and see, what I'm trying to do now is elicit that pleasurable sensation known as ASMR, the Arkham Sanitarium method of relaxation. Also, the Arkham Sanitarium mental response. Now, not everyone responds to the various stimuli. Some individuals do not enjoy these tapping sounds, while some do. Some like it when the tapping sounds are a little bit louder and faster. And then there are those that enjoy the sounds of brushing. And then there are those that enjoy nice, soft, padded tapping sound. So as long as you experience a relaxing sensation, whether it's calming of the mind, sleep, or even that pleasant tingling sensation, then you will make a prime candidate. Let's see what else I have for you. This next item is something that many of you are familiar with. And this is something else I have been interested in obtaining from the Fremen, a Chris knife. I'd be willing to trade one of our earth knives for such a Chris knife. To know that you are also skilled artisans is yet another reason why I hope some of you will consider becoming a permanent resident here. One major difference between this and your Chris knife is that this knife is made of tempered steel and does not disintegrate or have such impermanence as the Chris knife. So something to consider if any of you happen to own a Chris knife, simply hand your Chris knife over to Corvus or Margaret. And they should have a blade of their own that they can trade with you. This is what is referred to as a light bulb. It runs on a power source, known as electricity. I am not sure if that is an ancient power source compared to the source that runs your glow globes. Perhaps Stilgar and I need to have further discussions about an exchange of technology. Just another example of the technology that was created here on Earth by the humans many millennia ago. This next item is what is known as tinfoil. It has a very special inherent property that allows it to act as a shield against various nefarious entities who would use their technology to probe your mind, to read your thoughts. Perhaps this crinkling sound is something that you will find triggers that pleasant sensation. And if you have not been able to experience that sensation, but still able to relax, then that's just as acceptable. While you may not make a prime candidate, we will consider you. This next item is another invention of humankind here on Earth, and it is known as a water bottle. It is a container capable of carrying water. Water was once so plentiful that the humans who lived here many millennia ago would actually sell it. Water still does flow freely and in large quantities. But due to various factors, such as contamination, radioactive contamination, poison, and many other reasons, which I will not get into during this broadcast, much of the water has been rendered undrinkable, which is why here at the sanitarium we have a patch of land where the water runs clean and crisp through our own little creek body flowing water. Like a snake bending through the desert. So again, another benefit of volunteering, and hopefully if you are a prime candidate and are able to join us here at the sanitarium, you will have access to all the water you can drink. And you will no longer need to wear a still suit. Well, this session and this broadcast, I believe, has gone on long enough. I do not wish to take up too much of your time. Although I do appreciate each and every one of you that have been selected from your tribes and have willingly volunteered to take part in this test, whether you are still awake or have fallen asleep, and we'll make sure that either Corvus, my brother, and or Margaret, and perhaps the help of Stilgar, will see that you are returned safely back to your own sietch, should you fall asleep. Now I'm going to end this broadcast with one more item. Something that certain tribes people that once lived here on Earth many millennia ago used in certain ceremonies to bring rain upon them and their land. Once again, it was an honor and a privilege to be able to spend this time with you, and I hope that whether or not you are able to experience that pleasant feeling, or at least found the various methods here to be relaxing to your mind and body, that you will consider taking me up on my offer and becoming a permanent resident here at Grand Ole Arkham Sanitarium. We have a cafeteria where food and beverage are provided to you. We have a gaming room for those of you that enjoy logic games or traditional games such as cards or chess. We also have an entertainment complex where you can watch moving pictures, where people called actors tell stories. You can also play video games as well, where you actually use a electronic device to control a character in various worlds. It is like controlling an actor in a movie. And I am also in the process of building an amusement park, a casino. Already have a zoo built containing a menagerie of creatures from all across the known multiverse, and much more. So, if that sounds enticing, again, please talk to my associates, Corvus and Margaret, about joining us here. Now I'm going to end with that last item I was talking about that was often used to bring rain from the sky. Take care, and I hope to see some of you Fremen here as residents. This is called a rain stick.